Good morning, good morning. Deborah Fuller, good morning. JD Fuller, Fuller family, good morning. Connie Willis, good morning to you. Mr. Billy Perkins, good morning to you. God bless you. Danita Taylor, good morning. So that's the song my nephew would lead in children's church. Jackie Banks, Eli Banks, good morning. Jennifer Newsom, good morning to you. God bless you. Nobody can heal like he can. Sister Angela T. Stanford, good morning to you. God bless you. Dawson McLean, good morning to you. I believe all of us agreed that there's nobody greater, nobody greater, nobody greater than the Lord. Charlize Hicks, good morning to you. Ronald Liddell, Tom Liddell, good morning to you. God bless you. Couldn't find nobody. Nobody is greater. Kenya Roa, good morning to you. God bless you. Nobody greater. Nobody. Good morning, Marion Bolden. God bless you today. Nobody is greater than our God. Hallelujah. Nobody is greater than you. Cassandra Osborne Turner, good morning to you. God bless you. Nobody is greater. Hallelujah. Nobody greater. Good morning, Sister Juanita Saunders Singleton. Nobody greater. Nobody greater. Hallelujah. That's right, Jennifer. Hallelujah. Nobody. Nobody greater. I'm glad you're feeling better, Marion. Swelling in my shoulders going down. I can raise my arm. The pain was no joke. God bless you, man. God bless you. Buddy man, London Black, God bless you. Good morning to you. Ruth Harper, good morning to you. Amen. Thank God. Glad that you're feeling better. Amen. Glad that many who have been under the weather the last couple of weeks, amen, are getting better. Amen. COVID is still a reality. Amen. And thank God that everyone is getting better. I'm praise God for that. Amen. Good morning to you, Van Tinsley. God bless you. And again, welcome, my brothers and sisters, to Morning Glory. We give God praise for all of you. Another day that the Lord has made. We've been getting a lot of rain, but hey, it's all right. Amen. Thank God for the rain. We also want to keep in prayer those that are in Florida and Georgia and South Carolina who will be, experiencing hurricane conditions, flooding, and all of those things. Our hearts go out to all of those people. Amen. I was watching the weatherman on yesterday, and he was talking about a lot of people whose houses are on the shoreline. They will be lost. They will be destroyed. Those houses will definitely be destroyed, looking at the category of the hurricane and the winds and also the waves that shall hit the shoreline. Houses will be destroyed and washed into the ocean. Lord have mercy. Somebody's going to have to start all over again. My God, my God. Juanita Singleton says, praise report. She says, my colonoscopy found no polyps. They found two benign 5 years ago. But to God be the glory. My report is clean. Thank you all for your prayers. Amen. Amen. That is a praise report. Absolutely. That is a praise report. Thank God that everything is all right. Amen. Amen. Yes, Marion, we are praying for everyone in Florida. Amen. 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 Seemed like just a couple of weeks ago they had to go through the same type of thing. But, you know, at the same time, when you're dealing with tropical weather like that and you're on the coast like that, you have to deal with those things. Amen. Good morning, Sister Catherine Carter. Amen. And Walter Carter, God bless you on this morning. Sister Celeste Thomas Riley, good morning to you. God bless you. Sister Stacy Simmons, good morning to you as well. Amen. 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 Listen, I want to share with you today, listen, that if nobody cares for you, please understand that God cares for you. Amen. God cares for you. God cares for you. And I mean, how many of you believe that God cares for you? Amen. God cares. Amen. And, we're having, seems like family members are dying in our families and things are happening. People are dying and a whole lot of stuff is going on. Amen. But, sometimes you may feel like you're all alone. Amen. Sometimes you feel like you're just all by yourself. Amen. And it feels like no one cares. But God does care. God does care. Amen. And if God cares, God knows, my brothers and sisters, that's all you need. Amen. Please remember that God cares. Amen for you. Good morning, Deacon Yelder. Good morning, Brother Edwin. Amen. God bless you. Thank you for joining us on today. Amen. Mark 4. Bless you. Amen. Sandra Brown Cooper. Amen. Just windy here in Miami. Thank God. Amen. 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 Deborah Fuller says prayers also for some parts of Virginia where the effect will be left. Amen. Governor has already declared a state of emergency. Amen. We definitely, amen. All those involved, our heart goes out. Amen. Good morning, Andy Sessoms. Good morning, Tawanda Perry. God bless all of you. Amen. We thank God again for all of you on this morning. Amen. Amen. You know, and I enjoyed Bible study on yesterday, noonday Bible study. We're talking about, amen, spiritual warfare. Amen. I am so grateful, amen, for our Bible studies. Amen. We talked about in our evening Bible study, amen, Revelation chapter 13, how the Antichrist will be revealed. Amen. He was in an assassination attempt or in a battle or whatever it was. He was mortally wounded, and how he was miraculously healed. And guess what? People were amazed. People were fooled. People were bamboozled. And many began to worship him. Amen. He came into power. He came into power. Amen. And people began to worship him. He allowed the nation of Israel to rebuild the temple that Solomon once built. And they're going to say he must be the Messiah. Lord have mercy. And my brothers and sisters, I just want to say, you cannot get caught up in miracles, signs and wonders. Amen. Don't ever get caught up in signs and wonders. Don't follow somebody because miracles and signs and wonders follow them. Amen. Amen. But follow, amen, the God who is supernatural, the King of Kings and Lord of Lords, the one who cares for us. And it just lets us know how people will be bamboozled and fooled, and they will bow down and worship him. Lord have mercy. Lord have mercy. And so, you know, my brother says, we got to know the devices and the schemes of the devil. Amen. You got to know the word for yourself. And we're having good Bible studies. And you know, it's a blessing to me how God opened up the scriptures. And because it is his desire that we be not ignorant concerning his word. Amen. But he want us to have an understanding. And all our getting, he want us to get an understanding. Amen. So thank God for his word. Amen. Sister Charlize says, oh, yes, he does. I shut down and I asked God to reset my mind. He told me to get your butt up and get in morning glory. Amen. And remember that the battle, amen, you face is not yours alone. I felt a lupus flare up coming, and God shut it down. Hallelujah. I woke up refreshed, ready to go on in Jesus' name. So thankful for your prayers. Amen. Amen. Good morning, Sister Tammy. Well, God bless you. Again, my brothers and sisters, somebody cares. Somebody cares. Mark 4:38 says, Master, careth that thou that we perish? Psalm 55:22 says, cast your burden upon the Lord, and he shall sustain thee. He shall never suffer the righteous to be moved. Amen. 1 Peter 5:8 says, casting all your cares upon him, for he careth for you. My brothers and sisters, how often individual hearts bleed, bodies ache, and feet stumble, and eyes weep, and knees shake, and shoulders droop, and souls perish simply because they get to the feeling that nobody seemed to really care about them or about their circumstance. Amen. Or about their plight in life. Feeling like nobody cares. Amen. They become depressed, defeated, discouraged, dejected, despondent, delirious, demented. This attitude and feeling is caused by Satan himself, who being our chief enemy and adversary, endeavors to convince anybody and everybody he can to think and even believe that there is nobody who is concerned about or even interested in anything except their own situation, their own problems. Although this may be true, all too often with too many people, nevertheless, there is one who cares and who always cares. And his name, my brothers and sisters, should be no surprise to you, is Jesus, the Son of the Living God. The devil would do his best to convince you that should your hands become tired, nobody cares. Should your feet become weary, nobody cares. Should your eyes become dim, nobody cares. Should your lips become parched, nobody cares. Should your shoulders become drooped, nobody cares. Should your body become frail, nobody cares. Amen. Should your heart become broken, nobody cares. But he is wrong, my brothers and sisters, so very wrong, for there is one who cares, and his name is Jesus, the Savior of lost humanity. Satan, amen, will do all he can, amen, to get individuals to feel sorry for themselves by thinking that, amen, there is nobody who really cares whether their load is heavy, whether their joy is gone, whether their path is steep, whether their day is dreary, whether their night is long, whether their cross is cruel, or whether their pockets are empty. But Satan is a liar, my brothers and sisters. I said Satan is a liar, for someone does care, someone is concerned, someone does understand, someone is aware, and his name is Jesus, the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. Hallelujah. Good morning, Brother Bernard Close. God bless you, man. Someone cares. Amen. Satan will try, amen, his hardest to recruit members, amen, for his poor as me campaign or club, amen. He's telling you that nobody is the least bit interested or concerned in the fact, amen, that your peace has been overturned by perplexity, that your laughter, amen, has given way to weeping, that your nerves has been wrecked with frustration, that your patience has been hassled by tribulation, that your attractiveness has been marred by sin, or that your conscience has been tormented by your past lifestyle or activity. But Satan is completely mistaken, amen, for there is one who is interested in what is bothering you, amen. And he is interested in what is harassing you. And he is interested in what is provoking you. And his name is Jesus, the Lamb of God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Although there have been, amen, and will be times, amen, when it will appear that your banker doesn't seem to care, or that your doctor don't seem to care, or that your lawyer doesn't seem to care, or that your companion doesn't seem to care, or that your parents doesn't seem to care, or that your children doesn't seem to care. And there may even be times when it may appear that your church doesn't even seem to care, but you can fully be assured and confident and convinced and positive and certain that Jesus cares. Hallelujah. And that he always cares. Hallelujah. If nobody else seemed to care about you, your circumstances on your job, Jesus cares. If don't nobody else care about your situation in your home, Jesus cares. If nobody else cares about the existence in the world, your existence in the world, Jesus cares. If it seems nobody cares about your suffering in the hospital, Jesus cares. If it seems like nobody cares about, amen, your reputation in the community, Jesus cares. And if nobody seemed to care about about your destiny in the future and where you spend eternity. Let me tell you, Jesus cares. Hallelujah. If there have been times, amen, hard times, difficult times, discouraging times, when it seemed as though nobody cares about whether you lived or died, whether you came or went, whether you laughed or cried, whether you gave or took, whether you helped or hurt, whether you shouted or pouted, amen. And if there have been times when it seemed as though nobody else cares about whether you continued or quit, Jesus cared. Hallelujah. And he always has. And thank God, he always will. Hallelujah. There may be many people, amen, who don't seem to care should you become moral in your life, immoral in your lifestyle, but Jesus does. Amen. Whether you become selfish in your desires, but Jesus does. Whether you become proud in your attitude, Jesus does. Whether you become wicked in your imagination, Jesus does. Whether you become lustful in your appetite, Jesus does. Whether you are wasteful in your personality, Jesus does. And though some may not seem to care, should you, amen, become corrupt in your character, nevertheless, Jesus still cares. Hallelujah. The devil, amen, would have you think, my brothers and sisters, that it makes very little or no difference if you are unfaithful to your companion, if you are disobedient to your parents, if you are disloyal to your employer, if you are disrespectful to your teacher, if you are abusive to your children, if you are obnoxious to your friends, and that it makes no difference if you are cantankerous to your neighbors simply because nobody cares about you or about what you do anymore. But the devil is sadly mistaken, my brothers and sisters, for Jesus really cares. Hallelujah. The devil will pursue ways to convince you that nobody cares. Amen. If you were to become an alcoholic, if you were to become a drug pusher, if you were to become a prostitute, if you were to become a whoremonger, if you were to become a murderer, if you were to become a thief, if you were to become a criminal, hallelujah, if you were to become a liar, but the truth of the matter is Jesus cares, and probably a lot of others do as well. Amen. Are you hurting inside? Jesus cares. Are you being abused? Jesus cares. Are you under pressure? Jesus cares. Are you facing danger? Jesus cares. Are you losing ground? Jesus cares. Are you being treated poorly? Jesus cares. And are you harassed daily? Jesus cares all about it. Hallelujah. If Jesus cares about the birds in the air, he cares for you. Amen. If he cares for the fish of the sea, God knows he cares for you. If he cares for the flowers in the field, God knows he cares for you. If he cares about the lambs of the flock, he cares for you. Amen. If he cares for the fruit on the vine, he cares for you. If he cares about the beast in the land, he cares for you. And if Jesus cares about the trees of the forest, amen, he does, amen, then you can be absolutely certain that he cares about you. For God has placed greater value upon a single soul than he has and all the rest of creation. Amen. Therefore, he truly cares when your battle gets hot and heavy. He truly cares when you're going through rough and tough. He truly cares when your days get long and lonely. He truly cares when your valleys get dark and dreary. He truly cares when your situation get dismal and difficult. He cares, my brothers and sisters, when your way get wretched and weary. And he also truly cares when your nerves get shaken and shattered. Others may laugh, others may mock, others may criticize, others may provoke, others may harass, but Jesus will not. Amen. For he really cares for you. Hallelujah. I hope it's getting into your spirit now. When your eyes, amen, are filled with tears, Jesus cares. When your friends have forsaken and fled, Jesus cares. When your feet stumble along life's pathway, Jesus cares. When your heart, amen, skips a beat or two, Jesus cares. When children become rebellious and unruly, Jesus cares. When past torments, when your past torments you like a plague, Jesus cares, amen. And when your future, amen, causes you to panic with fear, you can be absolutely assured that Jesus cares. Amen. Aren't you grateful that he cares? Hallelujah. Furthermore, when we were out in sin, Jesus cared. When we were down in Egypt, Jesus cared. When we were lost in darkness, Jesus cared. When we were deep in trouble, Jesus cared. When we was proud in spirit, Jesus cared. When we were short in patience, Jesus cared. And when we were, amen, cold in our hearts, Jesus cared. And cared enough to do something about it. Hallelujah. Jesus didn't just say he cared. He did something to prove how much he cared. He cared enough, amen, that he took our worst and gave us his best. He took our hatred and gave us his love. He took our burdens and gave us his blessing. He took our sorrows and gave us his contentment. He took our guilt and gave us his grace. He cared enough that he took our anxiety and gave us his assurance. Blessed assurance. Hallelujah. Blissful assurance and delightful assurance. Blessed assurance. Jesus is mine. Oh, what a foretaste of glory divine. I'm an heir of salvation, purchased by God, born of his spirit, washed in his blood. This is my story. This is my song. Praising my Savior all the day long. You know I'm doing that. You know I can do that because he cares. Hallelujah. My God, my God, my God, my God. Hallelujah. 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 He cares. He cares, my brothers and sisters. He cares. Yes, Jesus cares. And to show how much he cared, he removed my dirt and gave me diamonds. Hallelujah. He removed my pebbles and gave me pearls. He removed my heartaches and gave me hallelujahs. Amen. He removed my rags and gave me a robe. He removed my bondage and gave me freedom. Hallelujah. He also removed my turmoil and gave me peace. He also removed my despair and gave me hope. Wonderful hope. Glorious hope. Loving hope. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Just how much does Jesus care? You may ask. He cared enough that he personally responded to my cry. He cared enough that he removed my shame. He cared enough that he cleansed my filth. He cared enough that he sanctified my desires. He cared enough, hallelujah, to satisfy my hunger. He cared enough to restore, he restored my song. He cared enough that he reached down and revived my soul, set my feet upon a solid rock, hallelujah. And he has not only done this for me, but he also done it for the whosoever crowd. Hallelujah. For whosoever shall call upon the name of the Lord shall be saved. Somebody know he cares. Somebody can testify he cares. Somebody can shout hallelujah that he cares. Somebody can say glory that he cares. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Does Jesus really care, you may ask? Just ask the woman who had a withered hand. And I'm sorry, the man who had a withered hand in Mark chapter 3. Amen. A hand which swung helplessly and hopelessly by his side. A hand with which he could do no normal labor. A hand which was, amen, of no personal benefit to himself or to others. Lord have mercy. That is, until Jesus came back. Hallelujah. Does Jesus really care? Just ask the woman who had suffered an issue of blood for 12 long years in Mark chapter 5, who had suffered many things of many physicians, who had spent all that she had nothing, amen, and nothing got better, but rather than grew worse, hallelujah, that is until Jesus passed by, hallelujah. Does Jesus really care? My brothers and sisters, just ask the man of Gadara in Mark 5, who was possessed with demons, who dwelt among the tombs, who continuously tortured himself, and who brought great fear to all who passed by. That is until Jesus came by and delivered him. I say again, does Jesus really care? Just ask the man who was sick of the palsy in Mark chapter 2, who was unable to walk or run, who was totally dependent on others to minister to his needs. Amen. Who was confined to the bed. Amen. That is until he was brought to Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Does Jesus really care? Just ask Jairus. Amen. One of the rulers of the synagogue in Mark 5, who had a little daughter. Amen. He deeply loved. A little girl, amen, who was his pride and joy. But a little girl that not only came to the point of death, but even passed through the death's veil. Amen. That is until Jesus came and restored her to life. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Does Jesus really care? Just ask the 5,000 men plus women and children. Amen. In Mark 6, who, after listening to the teachings of Jesus, were so exhausted, amen, to return to their homes without strength from additional food, amen, for which they had none, except for a small last lunch, that is, until Jesus blessed it and broke it. Hallelujah. Does Jesus really care? My God, just ask the man who was both deaf and unable to speak in Mark 7. Hallelujah. Amen. Who could neither hear nor communicate with others as to what he wanted to. Amen. Who had to, amen, depend upon others to help him through life. That is until Jesus spoke the word, be open, and the man was able to hear and he could talk. Hallelujah. How much does Jesus really care? You may ask. Go ahead and ask the woman who had been bound by the spirit of infirmity for 18 long years in Luke chapter 13. Amen. How much does Jesus care, my brothers and sisters? Amen. Go ahead and ask, amen, a certain man of Jericho who had been blind and sat by the wayside begging. Amen. In Luke chapter 18. How much does he care? Go ahead and ask Zacchaeus, amen, as he climbed down the sycamore tree and the Lord accompanied him to his home in Luke chapter 19. How much does he care? Go ahead and ask Mary and Martha as they stand rejoicing at the grave where Lazarus had been buried. Lord have mercy. How much does Jesus care? Go ahead and ask the Samaritan woman as she leaves her water pots at Jacob's well and runs into the town rejoicing in John number 4. How much does Jesus care? Go ahead and ask the man who had an infirmity, amen, for 38 long years, who had daily been carried, amen, to the pool of Bethesda in John number 5. How much does Jesus care? Go ahead and ask the woman who had been taken in the very act of adultery, amen, from the Pharisees and scribes, amen, and they desired to stone her, amen, to death in John chapter 8. Time and time again, my brothers and sisters, the scripture reveals that Jesus really cares. Amen. And although others have been indifferent to the circumstance, Jesus cares. Although, amen, others may have been insensitive towards your needs. Jesus cared. Although, amen, many others have been inattentive to the cry, Jesus cared. Although many have been incognizant of the situation, Jesus cared. Although others have been indignant concerning, amen, the brother and the sister, Jesus cared, amen. Although many others have been inhospitable towards others, Jesus cared. And although others may have been insensitive regarding your crisis, Jesus always proved that he truly cares. Yes, Jesus cares. Just ask the multitude who had been gloriously saved. Just ask the legion who had been completely delivered. Just ask the host who had been miraculously healed. Just ask the individual who had been abundantly blessed. Amen. Just ask the many who have been wondrously encouraged. Amen. Just ask the great number who have been greatly comforted. Just ask the scores of persons who have been joyfully revived. Yes, Jesus cares. Hallelujah. I think you got the point. Hallelujah. I think you got the point that Jesus cares. Amen. It doesn't matter whether you're rich or poor. He cares. Doesn't matter whether you are attractive or homely. Jesus cares. Doesn't matter whether you're male or female. Jesus cares. It doesn't matter whether you're black or white. He cares. Doesn't matter whether you're young or old. Jesus cares. Doesn't matter whether you're free or incarcerated. Jesus cares. It doesn't matter, my God, whether you native or foreigner. Jesus cares. Hallelujah. Furthermore, it doesn't matter whether your car is a Lincoln or a Lemon. He cares. Doesn't matter whether your house is a palace or a pigsty. He cares. It doesn't matter whether your clothes are designer or you got them from a rummage sale. Jesus cares. Doesn't matter whether your job is a statesman or a street sweeper. He cares. Doesn't matter whether your hair is long or straight or short or curly. Jesus cares. It doesn't matter whether your degree of education is university or kindergarten. Jesus cares. It doesn't matter whether you live on the right side of the track or on the wrong side. Jesus still cares. He cares about every breath you take. He cares about every heartbeat. He cares about every move. He cares about every meal. He cares about every desire. He cares about every hurt. He cares about, amen, every dilemma. Yes, every one of them. He cares. Hallelujah. And I'm completely convinced that he cares. How about you, my brothers and sisters? Amen. He came to the earth because he cared. He bore the cross because he cared. Hallelujah. He shed his blood because he cared. Hallelujah. He died for you and me because he cared. Hallelujah. He rose early Sunday morning from the dead because he cared. Hallelujah. He ascended to the Father because he cared. And furthermore, he is coming again because he still cares. Hallelujah. Yes, Jesus cares. Many have been able to face the unfaceable simply because they knew he cared. Many have been able to conquer the unconquerable simply because they knew Jesus cared. Many have been able to bear the unbearable because they simply knew that he cared. Many, amen, have been able to accept the unacceptable simply because they know he cares. Many have been able to suffer the insufferable because they knew that Jesus cared. Many have been able to forgive the unforgivable simply because they know that Jesus cares. And many have been able, hallelujah, to love the unlovable simply because they knew that Jesus Christ cared about them and their situation. Hallelujah. Yes, somebody cares. And his name is Jesus. Jesus, the lily of the valley. Jesus, the bright and morning star. Jesus, the great I am. Jesus, Emmanuel, God is with us. Jesus, my great company keeper. Jesus, my everything. Jesus, the wheel in the middle of a wheel. Jesus, the ladder that Jacob climbed. Jesus, our returning redeemer. Jesus, the King of Kings. Jesus, the Lord of Lords. Jesus, the suffering Savior. Jesus, who sits high and looks low. Jesus, a man who healed the sick. Jesus, who raised the dead. Jesus, who helped you and I. Jesus, who saved all of us. Jesus, hallelujah, is something about that name. And oh, how I love that name, because he cared for me. Hallelujah. 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 He cares. He cares. He cares. Hallelujah. And all of us can testify on this morning that he cares. So when you're going through, rebuke that feeling that nobody cares. When you're going through, when you're by yourself, rebuke that feeling that you're all alone. When you're by yourself, rebuke that feeling that you can't take no more. When you're by yourself, rebuke that feeling that nobody understands. Because the reality is, there is someone. And guess what? He may be the only one that understands. But guess what? That's really all that matters, is that he understands and he cares for all of us. Hallelujah. God bless you, Tawanda Perry. Amen. Tawanda said, Lord, have mercy. I needed this word, Pastor. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Deborah Fuller says, yeah, amen. There is no doubt that he cares. I'm overly assured. That's it. That he cares. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Yeah, Jennifer, he cares. Yeah, Marion, he cares. Amen. Amen, he cares. Yeah, it is a sermon title. It sure is. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. He cares. So listen. Listen. Be not weary in well-doing. All right? He cares for you. Take your licking and keep on ticking, because he cares for you. Amen. Amen. I know it seems like you're all by yourself sometimes. Amen. Your children are all grown now. They're living their lives. And some of them don't even check on you like they used to. But listen, don't worry about that. God still cares. God's still with you. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Please remember that. Don't you give up on life, because God cares. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. He cares, my brothers and sisters. He cares. He cares. Yes, he does. He cares. As we leave this morning, amen. Think on this song. So you think that you can't make it through. Hallelujah.
And you feel like,
and you feel like all hope is gone.
Is gone.
Hallelujah.
Just remember
God cares for you. Bless you, Ruth. Sometimes God will wake you up, and that's what you ought to do. Pray. Amen.
He cares.
He cares.
He cares
for you.
For you.
Hallelujah. Aren't you glad he cares for you?
So you think.
Hallelujah.
Bless you,
Shelly Curry. God bless you.
You just can't make it through.
Hallelujah.
And you feel
You feel like all of your hope, all your hope is gone. Hallelujah, hallelujah. But you've got to remember. Yes, sir. God cares for you. And he knows. He knows what's best for you. He cares. Yes, indeed. He cares for you. Hallelujah. Jesus knows. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Jesus knows. He knows how much you can bear. He knows, my brother and sister. So don't you give up. Don't you ever give up. And don't you ever give in. Hallelujah. You got to keep the faith. Hallelujah. Trust God. Trust Him. Trust Him. He cares, my brothers and sisters. He cares. Hallelujah. My, my, my. I know he cares. He cares for you. He cares. He cares for you. Yes, he does. Put your trust in Jesus. Somebody ought to shout, I know he cares. Hallelujah. He cares, my brothers and sisters. Yes, he does. He cares. Oh, he cares. He cares for you. Yes, he does. That's right. That's right, Sister Connie. I know he cares. Hallelujah. That's right, Deborah, in all caps. I know he cares. Yes, Stacy, he cares. He cares. My, 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 he cares. I know he cares. Hallelujah, hallelujah. He cares. Yes, he does. He cares for you. Amen. God bless you all on this morning. Amen. He cares. Amen. Let that marinate in your spirit all day. As you go through, amen, amen. There's no doubt he cares, hallelujah, amen. Ruth, amen with Tawanda. She needed this morning. Says she woke up at 3 and prayed and cried. I say yes to his word. Yes, amen, amen. Deborah Fuller says, thank you, Pastor, for morning glory. The strength and encouragement we receive is priceless. The Lord be praised, amen, amen. Hallelujah. Ruth says there's something about, I'm sorry, Deborah, amen. Ruth says something about them 3 a.m., those 3 a.m. wake-ups. Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. He cares, y'all. He cares for all of us. Thanks be unto God. Father, today, let no one leave this devotional today not knowing, not convinced that you care. But show them in some tangible way, if they need it, that you care. open a window, close a door, heal a body, answer a prayer, do whatever you have to do to assure them that you care. In Jesus' name I pray. And the people of God say amen, amen, and amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. That's right, Marion. I know he cares. Amen. The devil is a liar. The devil is a liar. The devil is a liar. Devil, I know he cares. I know he cares. Shut your mouth, devil. I know he cares. Hallelujah. 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 May God bless you. May God keep you. I see you tomorrow. Amen. Can you believe it? Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Anyhow, Friday. We'll be here tomorrow. My, my, my. God is so good, and we give him praise on today. Look, have a great day. I love you. We'll see you tomorrow at 7 o'clock for another Morning Glory. God bless you.